Yes, Miss O'Shea.
Ah, call me Molly, would you? Arthur, how is Dutch? I mean, how does he seem to you?
I'm about the same as usual, I guess.
I really love him, you know. But if he... Like he always says, loyalty is everything, so...
Arthur! Excuse me, Miss O'Shea.
What you want?
I bring a gift. The great gift of information.
So you got some tip-off, so now I can risk my neck and make you some money while you lounge around.
You know, Arthur, bitterness, it works on the inside as well as on your sour face.
If you say so, you could go find some other fool to run your errands.
Bill, come on over here. Will you be my other fool? You too, Charles.
What are you talking about?
Arthur's above a little stick-up I heard about.
No, I'm not.
You just said...
Hey, I'll do it, as long as you ride with us.
I got a serious medical condition.
Yes, you are a compulsive liar.
No need to be like that. Charles, have I ever lied to you?
I hardly know you.
Exactly. Now, you boys should do this. It's easy, and I'll only take a small commission for my information. But it's now or never.
Then it's never.
Oh, God help me. Fine. I'll do it.
Well, what is it?
It's a supply wagon carrying payroll, but very briefly unguarded, nice. Apparently. As it passes through a crossroads near here where there's an old ruined church before
it connects
with the rest of the wagon train. Very easy pickings.
As long as we get paid or you get shot, I'm happy.
You are a sick man, Arthur Morgan. A very sick man indeed.
This way, bunch of smart alecks.
How do you get wind of this, old man? We only been down here all of 5 minutes.
Well, you boys been off fishing or playing lawman or whatever the hell you've been doing. I've been getting down to business.
Finding the nearest grog house.
Hey, you don't want in on this, Williamson. That's fine by me. Do us all a favor. Head home.
Just give it a rest, you two.
Just have a little faith for once, will you? I've been scoping jobs like this since you fellers were knee-high to a grasshopper.
Once a decade, maybe. So what is it you've scoped here, exactly?
Well, I told you. There's a wagon with a lockbox passes through every week. They switch outriders just north of here, but the front wagon's by itself for a stretch before the last run down into Rose.
Okay, hold up here. We should cover our faces. They'll be passing through...
Oh, it's bandana time.
Crossroads up ahead.
Chat, bandana time. We haven't had a bandana time in a minute. There we go. Bandana time.
When?
Soon, Williamson. My sakes. I should be due any time now.
Let's keep this quiet and clean. Nobody needs to die here.
There! You see, gentlemen? Just like clockwork.
We're not that far away from camp.
Stop the wagon! I said, stop the damn wagon!
Whoa! Now, don't try anything stupid, and we won't do anything unkind.
You know, boys, I don't want to get shot, but this is a mistake. I work for Cornwall Kerosene and Tar, Mr. Leviticus Cornwall.
Oh, great.
So you know him?
Who doesn't?
I hear he's rich enough to share the wealth around and not miss it too much.
Oh, he'll miss it.
Okay, why don't you check out around the back?
Arthur, help me out here.
say something?
Oh, great.
Let's go.
Arthur, let's go. Yeah.
Go, go, go. Oh, God.
Most guarded wagon in goddamn history. How loud I know. Everyone, stay tight. You go fast. All right, Miller's gone. Keep going. Shit.
I'm not shooting if I don't have to.
Quick! Get off the trail! Into the woods! Let's shake him and get back to camp!
No, we need to find a place to lie low. We can't risk leading Cornwall's men to camp.
Alright!
Whoa! Let's hide in here. Quick!
Go on. Get out of here.
Get out of here. Go on.
Get out of sight.
Stay until dark, and then we'll sneak out of here.
Charles, you keep watch for now.
Sure.
Well, we get some rest.
Haven't eaten the bandana in a while, chat.
All right. Let's try and get out of here.
Hey, shit.
Absolutely. Shut up, old man.
Look, I was just trying to...
Shut up.
There's a light over by the house.
Damn. I ain't in there. Let's just keep this calm. See what happens.
Is this your place? Kinda. And you didn't hear nothing? Why don't you just tell me, partner, what you heard?
Tell me what you heard.
I don't... Maybe I heard some noises out by the barn a while ago. Ain't me.
Better not be. All right. Group forth. Lo, go check out the barn.
Sir.
They're coming.
Well, the place looks deserted enough.
Sure. You head inside. I'll go around the back.
Place looks empty to me. Now, the old guy up there is full of crap.
I don't think they're here. Don't see any horses.
Come on, let's head back. Boss! Place is empty! Shit!
Looks like we're shooting our way out of here, fellers!
You're in a situation here!
We got more of the past on this side.
You'll be sorry.
More on the right here. And
move, Bill.
This fella really.
I am I shooting off people's hats? No, just as he tripped over the other guy's body. Oh my God! Run, Arthur! Run into the trees, Arthur! Back to work. All right, I think we're good here.
We all still alive?
Yeah, just about.
Yeah, I'll deal with you later.
We got some money, didn't we?
Sure, but now we got Cornwall on our backs.
It was an honest mistake.
Hey, leave it. Go on, get out of here. Every man split up. Go on, run quick.
Good luck, gents.
Stay quiet and move.
offer.
Yes, kid.
You got a lot on?
Just hunting for all this hillbilly gold that Dutch and Hosea seem to think is out there just waiting to be stolen. Why?
I got something. Could be good.
Yeah?
Yeah, I was in Rhodes talking to some of the colored folk. They said there's a gang of fools holed up in the swamps east of here who think their war ain't never ended.
The Civil War?
Yeah, apparently it's still raging in these fools' minds 30 years later.
Okay.
That ain't my point. These ignorant fools are weapon dealers. And in their dealings, sometimes sit on a decent pile of cash. Yeah, been selling weapons to Cuba and South America for years. Anyway, the old boy I was talking to reckon there might be a bunch of cash just sitting around. And failing that, maybe a nice stash of weapons.
It's just a bunch of crazies, Gardner?
Exactly.
Well, worth taking a look at least, isn't it?
That was my thinking. Said it was at some place called Shady Bear, deep in the woods.
Okay.
I was hoping you'd be in. If it's how they told it, it's gonna be something all right.
We'll see.
Let's see what we got.
Come on, it's this way. On me.
All right, girl. You know, I might have met these crazies before.
You've been drinking again?
No. Well, yes, but no, that's not how I might have met them. I think some of them harangued me and Sadie when we were coming back with supplies.
Mrs. Adler? Mm.
Yeah. And Mrs. Adler did just fine. More than fine, actually.
Interesting.
She's terrifying. But I got a notion these fellas is one and the same.
Yeah, we won't find no shortage of angry Peckerwood idiots in the state of Lemoyne. That's for sure.
Is it really that different in this state? We haven't come far.
It seems like it is.
These boys got a manner about them that I haven't necessarily noticed.
All respect, Mr. Morgan. You wouldn't notice. Might call you a nigger lover. They see us riding.
Whoa!
Like this. But most of it is a glance or a word. And after that, a visit in the night.
Out west, it's...
Out west is out west. And you're all who you are. Decent folks. But some places down here, they judge differently.
Well, then,
we're about to kill some racists.
So easy for you, Lenny.
I think this is going to be my favorite mission so far.
Well, I guess their gold's still shining. And their guns still shoot. So I'm game for robbing any and every one of these bastards for all they got.
Okay, then.
Plus, it beats being lynched back in Blackwater with all of you by my side.
I guess it does.
Feels like we're close. It's a rundown old plantation house down in the bayou somewhere.
Let's take it slow. Be cautious. If, like you say, these crazies are sitting on weapons, we're gonna wanna strategize a little before getting shot at.
Oh, I see it.
Of course. They said find the old battlefield and keep on going.
Yeah, I've been here before. I can see the wrecked old Civil War weaponry. Where are the wrecked old Civil War holdouts?
See that church up ahead? They're supposed to use it as an outpost. Heard they got men going between here and the big house all day.
Okay.
Look at this field. Imagine getting caught up in a fight like this.
Yeah, I don't care to.
PlayStation, Dave.
Hold those reins in. Let's just take a look around the place.
I hear you. It doesn't look like anyone's here.
We don't know that for sure. Let's have us a nosy.
Hear that? Someone's on the track.
I'm drawn. Regular PlayStation. The original.
Look there. A wagon.
Let's see where he's going. You're on me now.
Right behind you.
Let's keep our distance. Just two fellas out on the road.
Hey, that looks like dynamite in the back there?
It looks like we're on to something.
Any more questions, Dave?
I think I see something. End of the avenue, between the trees.
Might be it. Might be. Keep it steady.
Hey, big plantation house. Must be Shady Bear. I reckon we can leave our mounts up there, off the trail.
Good enough to me.
Are you coming?
Stereo.
Come on. We can get a view on them from that wall up there. Bring your sighted rifle, okay?
Yes, sir.
I'll take the other side. You get in cover there.
Wait for Lenny. I'm waiting for Lenny. Can I shoot out the dynamite?
Do you see anything?
Yes. Yes. They're here, all right.
That's so good.
They're armed. Down by the road. We'd do well to draw them into one spot if we're gonna make a pass at this. What else? You got men covering the house? All right, some tents. I know dynamite crates when I see them.
You got something, right?
Oh, we got something. We can hit them head on, fight them honest. Or you could go down there acting friendly.
Friendly? With these folks?
Just draw them into one spot, and I'll start shooting.
Well, that might be the dumbest idea I've ever heard. But hey, I'm always up for a performance. You gonna make a call?
I'm gonna hit them head on. You save your play acting for Jose and the girls.
Fine by me. Waiting on you.
Prepare for your guns and your money. Give them up.
No!
Time to switch weapons and run. Run the pace. Oh! I should probably take cover. Aim for the head. That's four shots in a row. Where's his body? There it is. Is that all of them?
Quick! Any men in the area would have heard that. They might be on the way.
I think my plan went out pretty well.
Sounds like a plan.
I don't know what you're talking about. And also... What am I supposed to be doing? Searching for stuff?
You got anything?
Not yet.
Rip. Come on. What am I looking for here?
This one looks good. Search it.
Yes, sir.
Here. Come on. This is full of new rifles.
We can sell those, right?
You sure can. We'll check the rest later. Now, come on. Let's go.
You know the fight ain't over.
Go. Get this back to camp.
I've been wanting to complete this game. I've never finished it, so I want to finish it. And in May, at some point. Ooh, turn.
Go. Let's
or sorry, not May. June 19th is the release date of Last of Us 2. And I'm come so on. Excited to play that game.
Doing some business with your brothers back there.
You don't look like any kind of folk we deal with.
Our business was conducted to the satisfaction of all parties. Until now, that is.
Nope. No. Something don't feel right about this. Not him and not you neither, Yankee. Get these lying bastards!
Austin, let's go! They might be on. Can't see anyone chasing us.
I should think we're out of the woods then, so to speak.
Boy, oh boy.
You did good.
We did it.
Well, let's get to camp before saying anything like that.
I know Sean's been bringing in quite a lot lately, and I wanted to... It's good to have something to show like this.
Sean's a loudmouth bragger. Don't worry about what Sean does.
I like them, you know?
Well, so do I. Guess for better judgment. Just, you worry about you. He wasn't on Leviticus Cornwall's train with me. We had to dig him out of Blackwater.
But...
And now, button up. Me and Dutch, and everyone who counts, we know what you do for this gang. We notice. Keep it up. You're gonna start seeing things change for you.
Okay, then. Okay. Thank you, Arthur.
Man, Arthur is a nice guy.
Hey, the camp's in these trees up here.
Let's get there.
Lenny, coming back.
These are fine rifles.
Right?
I'm gonna keep one, just for me. Hey, I always enjoy riding with you, kid. You know how to fight.
Hey, you too. Anytime, Arthur.
What are you doing?
Selling it back to where it came from.
Why?
I ain't got a market for it.
they made it, they must have someone to sell it to. Stuff look kind of lonely out here. I think we'll cut ourselves a deal.
I get you.
You and Dutch was just doing your duty when you requisitioned it. Now I'm doing mine.
All right. I should get going now.
Why couldn't he do this without him?
Good luck.
Thank you, John. We'll see you later. Dutch asked him to look into something to do with the Braithwaite horses, I think.
Sure, okay.
Okay, let's head out to the Braithwaite's place. You know the way?
Yeah, I've been there. So, what exactly are we doing? This is the moonshine we took after blowing up the Braithwaite still, right?
I think the good citizens taking the trouble to return their stolen goods deserve some reward, don't you? Then it's time we made a formal introduction, like Dutch told us. Look, these are two big old plantation houses. All I keep hearing is they hate each other so much they can't see past it.
I know. I've seen it. There's a gray boy and a Braithwaite girl carrying on a secret affair. I've been, well, helping them.
The mind boggles. You think they're of use?
Not sure. They don't seem too involved in the rest of it, but maybe.
Well, I'm sure there's money in this for us somewhere if we can get in the middle of it.
Here we are.
Modest little homestead, isn't it? Hello, gentlemen. How are you?
What's that in the back there?
Moonshine, my fine fellow. May I have a word with the man of the house?
The man of the house is a lady. Mrs. Catherine Braithwaite.
May I speak with her? I want to discuss a business opportunity. I mean no harm. No harm at all. You may happily shoot me if I do.
Okay, okay. Well, she's at the house. We'll be watching you.
You heard the man. Driver, proceed, please.
Driver. He just said, driver, proceed, please. Please. Mm-mm-mm. Yeah. Yeah.
What you want?
Found something. Out in the hills. Thought maybe you was in the market for it.
For what?
Some liquor.
I ain't in the market for what's already mine.
The way we see it, it's ours. Well, with us possessing it, and I checked all over. For the life of me, I couldn't see your name on it. Whoa. Relax. I ain't here to rob you. No, it seems that's easy enough. Why not do a deal? What do you sell that stuff for?
$1 a bottle.
You give us 50 cents.
It's already ours.
Well, look on it as a reward for finding the property. Alternative is we go sell it someplace else.
The alternative is you get shot.
Now, who wants to get shot over a bottle or two of liquor?
Pay the man.
Pleasure doing business with you. And listen, we didn't take it, at least not without orders from...
Oh, I know exactly who gave you your orders. Old Sheriff Gray. You know what? I don't want it. In fact, sir, now you can do me a favor. There's an extra $10 if you do. Drive the stuff into Rhodes, head over to the tavern run by Mr. Gray, and give the stuff out for free.
Mama!
Hush now. I believe they call that a promotional expense.
As you wish, madam.
You boys come back sometime and tell me how you made out. Maybe we'll play a little cribbage.
The all right. Fuck is
next
crib?
Stop, the Rhodes Saloon.
Here we go.
So I finally sold those Cornwall bonds. Got close to $1,000 for them.
Wow.
Wanted more, but not bad considering how hot they were, especially after that bloodbath in Valentine.
That's a lot of money.
Oh, not bad at all.
Apparently, Cornwall's been pumping a lot of cash into the Pinkertons. Wants to keep their full effort on going after gangs like us.
Yeah, that don't surprise me.
pirate. This could get ugly. You and Dutch already have that thing going on in town with the sheriff.
Yeah, Mr. Gray.
That's it. Now we're inserting ourselves in his blood feud. We'll need something.
I ain't playing dress up. You know my feelings about that.
Of course you're not. You're a clown's idiot brother.
Isaiah, please.
I'm the clown. You're the brother turned idiot. Just look sad and keep quiet. Even you can do that, Arthur.
Oh, I have to.
Put this hat on. Smoke this pipe. Bring your lip forward just a bit. Squint. Oh, perfect.
Hey, what about you?
Shh. You can't speak. You're turned idiot. Right. Broke poor Mammy's heart. There, there, Fenton. There, there. Don't get mad now.
All right, let's give out some liquor.
Okay, Fenton, stay calm now. For Mama, she loved you so.
Just a shame you had to strangle her in a rage, right? Grab two cases of that stuff and follow me.
Brother Fenton, don't mind him, don't madden him. He's turned idiot.
Killed our mother, but it weren't his fault. How'd you boys like a couple of bucks? I bet you would. One for each of you.
We're in the new trade of advertising, which is an American art form about ensuring people buy the correct things.
I don't know.
One more dollar. Says give us half an hour. What harm can we do in half an hour?
Go along now. Enjoy the money! Come along, Fenton. Just hand out the liquor. Gentlemen! Gentlemen! My name is Milton. That's my brother Fenton. He's a bit funny, but boy, can he pour drinks fast. For the next 30 minutes, the drinks in this here bar, in this here town, are entirely free. Yeah. The only rule is that you gotta drink them. So hurry up, put old Fenton to work. Yeah. Don't get him mad, though. His mama made him mad, and we buried her. Poor thing. Now come up to the bar, everybody. Come on, fellas, it's your lucky day.
I'll have one, Ben.
A gift. Bounty. It's a sin to look at a gift horse. When I see a gift horse, I look at my eyes.
Oh, that's
it. So
just keep them coming.
Don't be shy, boys. Don't be shy. It's the lady above the city.
Mr. Gray won't be happy about this.
I'm good at this.
Hey, send a couple this way, will ya?
Work, friend. Work, you dumb bastard.
Oh, wife is gonna kill me. All the way out for milk.
I'll have one, Fenton.
Drink up.
Good evening, gentlemen.
Quiet libation.
You.
Me?
You're the bastard who stole the liquor we was gonna buy.
Gentlemen, we're in advertising. Come on in and have a drink.
That's our goddamn liquor.
An honest mistake.
Boys, get him.
Oh, what the hell? No.
Yeah, I'm glad I'm taking all these shots for you. Oh, cool. That was something else.
Jesus, all this over a few bottles of booze?
I reckon it's more they don't want another gang on their patch.
Okay, pull off the road here.
Yep. All right, we're good.
Remind me never to take up a career in, what was it?
Advertising.
You think that woman set us up?
No, I don't think so. Maybe. This place is odd.
Yeah. I keep seeing those fellas.
Some local militia. Clearly not too happy to have some new competition. I'll go visit old Ma Braithwaite, see what's what.
Why?
We've been making money. The chest is filling up again, slowly but surely. Part of me thinks we just get ourselves good and lost. But we still need a lot more money before that can happen. So, for now, let me go give old Mrs. Braithwaite some of this moonshine as, well, let's call it a peace offering.
Sure.
That was fun, Fenton. We'll make an actor of you yet.
I'll go speak to Dutch.